plan to tell him.
This is a special report from CBS News, The Attack on the President. I'm Doug Poling in New York. President Reagan is recuperating tonight in a Washington hospital following the attempt on his life this afternoon, the shooting with a .22 caliber pistol. Also shot during the same incident outside the Washington Hilton Hotel was James Brady, the White House press secretary, along with a Secret Service agent, Timothy McCarthy, and a Washington, D.C. policeman, Thomas Delahanty. CBS News correspondent Neil Strauser is at the White House tonight. Neil, what are we being told now about the president's condition?
Well, we've just heard within the past 45 minutes ago or so that the president went into surgery cracking jokes and he came out of surgery cracking jokes. A little differently now, he's having to do it on paper, but the White House tells us that in the recovery room he couldn't talk because of the tube still in his mouth, but he gave his doctors a handwritten note saying, all in all, I'd rather be in Philadelphia. And of course, White House aide Lynn Nofziger told us earlier that Mr. Reagan going into surgery told the doctors, I hope you're all Republicans. And the doctors have told us since that their answer was, today we are all Republicans.
I think, Neil, that people find this most remarkable, that the president, after having suffered this bullet wound in the lung within inches of his heart, is able to speak this way and joke this way. Of course, we know that no vital organ was struck, but he is 70 years old, and what are they saying that this says about his overall condition, physical condition?
They're saying it shows he's in very good physical condition, but you can also say, of course, the lung was struck, which is a vital organ, but they're pointing out that he was never in very serious danger, and actually the bullet lodged several inches from his heart. It wasn't a case of, as we heard a great deal earlier this afternoon, that his heart was missed by just about an inch or so. In fact, the bullet might just have passed around his body, had it hit a rib a different way, but it did glance off a rib and did lodge in his lung. But the surgery, though, it's always serious surgery when you have to go into a body. But Dr. Dennis O'Leary told us that it does show that the man is in very extraordinary physical condition, and the prognosis for recovery is excellent.
That was the next question. There's no doubt, or there seems to be no doubt, in the minds of the surgeons and the doctors attending Mr. Reagan that he will make a complete recovery.
That seems to be the case, and that also was repeated to us here not so long ago by Vice President George Bush, who said that the prognosis is for complete recovery. That was the word he got from the doctors.
And they're also saying, I believe, that he will be able to do some work while he was recuperating in the hospital.
Oh, yes, they're saying that by tomorrow that the president will be able to make any decisions necessary for the office. He'll be hospitalized for a couple of weeks, but he should be feeling very little pain and not having much need for sedation after this night.
Hospitalized a couple of weeks. Is that about how long they're saying he will be there?
That was the guess, yes.
All right, now the man, though, who's not in such good condition is James Brady, the White House press secretary.
We were told by Lynn Nofziger again not so long ago that Brady's doctor now feels the prognosis is better than it was earlier today. Brady underwent lengthy surgery for that head wound. The doctors have said he might possibly have suffered some brain damage, but according to Brady's doctor now, his vital signs are stable. The reflexes of the pupils of his eyes are normal, indicating apparently that the brain stem is operating. It's still a case of holding the breath as far as the very genial and well-liked Jim Brady is concerned. And his condition is still critical.
And the other, the Secret Service agent who was wounded along with him, Timothy McCarthy.
He suffered a chest and stomach wound, a single bullet also, but it penetrated the chest and also into the abdominal cavity. But he, after undergoing surgery, according to the doctors at George Washington University Hospital, is doing extremely well.
And we also understand that the Washington policeman, Thomas Delahanty, who was also shot and wounded, is in serious but stable condition. Now, Vice President Bush arrived back in Washington about how long ago, Neil?
Shortly after 7 o'clock Eastern time. And he went immediately into about a half an hour meeting with the top officials and members of the cabinet in the Situation Room at the White House. And appeared not too long after that to tell us how heartened he was by the news from the doctors about President Reagan and also to assure us that the people should know that the American government is functioning fully and effectively. And this seemed to be the White House message tonight.
You've been listening to a special news update on President Reagan from CBS News. Now back to the CBS Mystery Theater over WHAM Rochester.
I have a letter from the mayor saying that my demonstration was indeed held